Hey guys, I've decided to start up my own YouTube channel all about mudlarking and what that really is. And I know what most of you are thinking, mudlarking, what is that? So let me help you out. Simply put, mudlarking, even though it's not obvious in the name, is a form of archaeology where you can find really cool things left behind on the River Thames in London. While it is a little bit of a niche hobby, it does play an important role in the understanding of London's archaeological history, and you get to find some pretty cool things down here.
So without further ado, let's see what I can find.
While it's not a very precious find, I thought I'd note that this to me looks like a bit of a Roman roof tile. It'd kind of be in a U-shape, there'd be other ones kind of semi-circular, which would slot in between them to make Roman roof tiles. Again, nothing too spectacular, precious, and probably something I'll be leaving behind today, but still, lovely bit of history either way. Just on the surface a moment ago, I found what looks almost to me like a human mold. Now, it's very, very worn, which is kind of typical of very old teeth because they were very bad at grinding grain down, and so you can find lots and lots of bits of kind of sand and bits which would come off kind of mortars when grinding down grain or herbs or things like that, and it would wear their teeth flat quite quickly. So I might hold on to this and then see if anyone can identify that. But that looks to me very much like a human molar. Quite rare to find one that looks like this, so I believe it might very well be.
Well, no luck up that way, but it's getting a bit dark now, so I thought I'd take out the head torch and see what we can find.
This little piece here that I've just found seems to be a little bit of a typecase letter. It's a, might be a G or an E. Anyways, long before typing or kind of typewriter machines were even available, they put a lot of these little letters into a line and press them down to kind of print large amounts at a time. Look at that, lots more typecase letters all around here. I wonder what must have happened. It's curious. There's lots of little pieces around here that look almost like coins. Is that one a coin? It's hard to tell. There's so many bits that are just oysters and bits of shells. And you can't really tell until you get back home and kind of give them a little bit of a clean, or, you know, put them on the electrolysis until you can really tell what they are. Looks like a little bit of lead which they used to hold together the glass. So yeah, these lovely little bits and pieces of lead we used to sandwich the lead for stained glass windows in cathedrals and churches. Tiny find, but my find of the day might be this little piece here. Looks to me like a little bead. Looking at that condition and kind of location, it might even be Roman. Lovely.
Well, I've just gotten back, and unfortunately I didn't find anything too spectacular today, which just shows a little bit of how mudlarking really takes a lot of patience and a very keen eye. So, I just thought, as I'm back and I've got some finds on the table, I might as well show you what other things I found kind of on a regular day mudlarking. I mean, my last time on the Thames, I found this lovely Bartman face. Now, these lovely pieces here date to the 17th, sometimes 18th century. They were filled with wine and they were made in Germany, but often they were taken back during the plague from Germany and filled with kind of blood or fingernails or all kinds of gruesome bits and then stuck under people's doorways and sealed in the hopes that the plague wouldn't enter their house. So a little bit of history there. These little bits are Roman mosaic bits. I've got some lovely beads like my one from today inside this lovely Tudor candle holder. Some bits of Roman, some lovely little clay pipes, which, you know, very common along the Thames. What kind of bits and pieces like this? Of course, lovely little dice. So this is really just my recent finds, which I'm still cleaning off and stuff like that. But as you can see, there's really quite a few of them, quite a few bits and pieces you can find lying across the River Thames foreshore. Anyway, stay tuned if you want to see more interesting things like this on a slightly more eventful mudlark. And yeah, I'll keep you updated.